The transforaminal epidural steroid injection technique under fluoroscopy can be performed using several approaches depending on the specific clinical scenario. These are mainly subpedicular, infraneural, and retrodiscal. The choice of technique depends on several factors, including the pathology being treated, the patient's anatomy, and the physician's experience and preference. Join our masterclass membership today and unlock a treasure trove of knowledge. Benefit from twice-weekly videos, including inspiring lectures, clinical case discussions, and image interpretation insights. Elevate your skills and connect with like-minded doctors. Subscribe now for a brighter professional future. Subpedicular approach. The subpedicular approach, also called the postganglionic or conventional technique in some literature, involves inserting the needle between the pedicle and the exiting nerve root. This technique targets the peripheral region of the dorsal root ganglion, intending to inject the steroid into the nerve sleeve or hydrodissect the possible nerve root adhesion. It is often used in cases of radicular pain due to disc herniation or stenosis. The primary advantage of the subpedicular approach is a lower risk of puncturing the radicular artery or damaging the nerve root. In this technique, the spinal needle is positioned within the safe triangle, an area bounded by the pedicle, exiting nerve root, and posterolateral border of the vertebral body. However, in many cases of radiculopathy due to stenosis or disc herniation, the course of the nerve root is often upward to this conventional injection site due to the protruded disc. This anatomical fact
means there may not always be a guarantee that it would be a safe triangle to avoid the nerve root puncture. Also, we would not be sure the injected steroid would spread to the area of nerve root impingement at the above disc level. This limitation of the subpedicular approach led to the development of the infraneural or preganglionic approach. This newer technique targets the needle insertion more medially and inferiorly, aiming to place the steroid injection closer to the site of neural impingement, particularly in cases where the site of impingement is rostral to the conventional injection site. This adjustment in needle positioning increases the likelihood that the injectate covers the intended area of nerve root impingement more effectively. The infraneural approach, also known as the preganglionic approach, is another technique used for transforaminal epidural steroid injections. This technique focuses on the upper aspect of the level below the dorsal root ganglion and the medial aspect of the same level of the dorsal root ganglion. For example, in an L4 infraneural approach, the target would be the upper aspect of the L5 DRG and the medial aspect of the L4 DRG. This technique addresses pathology in the anterior epidural space, particularly in regions around the posterior annulus or in areas with stenosis. However, unlike the subpedicular approach, it does not directly target the DRG or the nerve root itself, unlike the preganglionic terminology suggests. It is often employed for similar indications as the subpedicular approach, with the most common radicular pain due to disc herniation or stenosis. One significant advantage of this technique is its potential to provide a more effective treatment for specific pathologies in the anterior epidural space. Moreover, it maintains a lower risk of nerve damage. The preganglionic approach positions the needle more rostrally than the conventional technique, with the needle tip located at the inferior aspect of the supra-adjacent neural foramen, immediately dorsal to the posterior annulus. This placement is close to the disc, where the traversing nerve root is closest. Fluoroscopic landmarks utilized for needle positioning in this approach are analogous to those used for intradiscal procedures, i.e., lateral to the superior articular process and parallel to the superior endplate of the vertebral body. The benefit of this technique is that it enables placement of the injectate at the epidural preganglionic site of neural impingement and allows the injectate to descend to the intraforaminal and epidural portion of the exiting nerve root. Consequently, this can provide more comprehensive coverage and washout of inflammatory material around the site of impingement. The preganglionic approach inserts the needle more medially and inferiorly than the subpedicular or conventional approach. This strategy is designed to avoid direct contact with the dorsal root ganglion, a sensitive structure that can cause pain and potentially nerve root injury when irritated. The overarching goal of this approach is to place the injectate as close as possible to the site of neural impingement, usually at the level of the supra-adjacent intervertebral disc. This method optimizes the therapeutic effect of the injection by facilitating a more effective washout of the inflammatory disc material. Retrodiscal approach. This method is similar to the infraneural approach, but the target is further toward the inferior end. Unlike the previous two techniques, this approach is not directed at the exiting nerve root. Instead, it aims at the posterior annulus with the intent to deliver the medication into the posterior annular tear area. This approach is primarily indicated for discogenic pain and posterior annular tear. The main advantage of the retrodiscal approach is that it may allow for better deposition of steroid medication into the intradiscal or torn annulus area. While this approach also carries a low risk of intravascular injection or nerve damage, intradiscal injection is intentionally or accidentally common. Unintentional posterior deployment of transforaminal injection. Occasionally, technical failures may arise with the subpedicular approach due to anatomical variations or bony abnormalities that hinder the desired needle advancement. In such cases, guiding the needle tip towards the nerve root and pedicle close to the anterior epidural space may be challenging, preventing the needle from reaching the ideal target area. In these situations, two alternatives may be considered. The first option is withdrawing the needle and switching to the infraneural or retrodiscal approach. These alternative techniques may circumvent the obstruction and facilitate accurate needle placement. The second option involves continuing with the current needle placement and deploying the contrast to confirm the nerve sleeve, despite the needle not reaching the ideal target area. This approach, often termed the unintentional posterior deployment of transforaminal injection, although not the first choice, can still be beneficial in some instances. In this unintended posterior deployment, the needle trajectory tends to be more posterior than the traditional subpedicular approach. This can sometimes result in a more lateral and posterior injection of the contrast and injectate, potentially targeting different areas within the epidural space. It is important to note that even though the needle might not reach the intended target, the epidural spread of the injectate could still provide therapeutic benefit. Let me review the locations of the dorsal root ganglia in the lumbar region. L1-L3 DRGs, almost all of these DRGs were located in the foraminal or extraforaminal area. The foraminal region is confined between the medial and lateral borders of the pedicle, while the extraforaminal region is lateral to the lateral border of the pedicle. L4 DRGs, all of the L4 DRGs were located in the foraminal region, which is between the medial and lateral borders of the pedicle. L5 DRGs, most of the L5 DRGs, 94.3%, were located in the foraminal region. A small percentage, 5.7%, were located in the intraspinal region, which is medial to the medial border of the pedicle. This occurrence of intraspinal DRGs was found only at the L5 level. It is my conclusive message. First and foremost, understanding the mechanisms of pain, pathology, and the location of the dorsal root ganglion is critical. From this understanding, you can design different types of transforaminal approaches and plan the needle trajectory accordingly. Remember, the focus should always be on the needle trajectory. If you encounter difficulties with the original plan, don't hesitate to modify the needle trajectory during the procedure. At the end of the day, the goal is to deliver the medication to the specific area, regardless of the type of procedure and needles you choose. Thank you for watching. I hope this has helped you understand transforaminal injections and their targets. I look forward to seeing you in the following videos.